belong.
And that's the way it is. And, you know, people think, you know, that we just get stuff by just being handed to us. No. He got his eyes on everything that we get. Praise the Lord. Shame Brother Frank can't be with us tonight, but, you know, he said he had to work tomorrow all day, but he thought.
Yeah, it's because Mike's funeral was the day and half of the plant went to him.
Yeah. So, anyway, it'll be Frank's going tomorrow, and we'll have an easy day. We never know what, you know, the Lord can do that.
Yeah.
The Lord will put him on the easy spot that morning. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Be so thankful, though, for what God has done. You know, he's a blessing God, always blessing. Hallelujah. He can pay your bills for you. Praise the Lord.
Yes, Lord, he will.
He will. He'll pay your bills. Praise the Lord. We're going to go here tonight and open up in prayer. Praise the Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus, we're just so thankful tonight, Lord. We're back in your house, Lord. Lord, if you give us opportunities, Lord, and the right mind to decide tonight, make up my mind which way we're going to go. And Lord, we made up my mind to come here. And Lord, our mind is in this place, Lord. Lord, a place where you can feel your spirit, Lord, and see the anointing work and the Holy Ghost move here in this place, Lord. Lord, we thank you for the accommodation that we have. Lord, we just thank you for the building that we have to come and praise you in, Lord, that you made a way for us, Lord. We just so thankful tonight, Lord. Glory be to God, Lord. Tonight, Lord, as we pray for the families of Elizabeth, all glory to God, Charlie, and Hattie, and Jason, when he met that liver, we just hope everything went good today, Lord. In your name, Lord. Lord, early this morning, Lord, going down 66, I call on you, Lord, to touch him and be with him, and you do the surgery, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Lord, we know you're so special, Lord. Glory to God, Lord. We know that we got the best doctor in the world when we have you, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Lord, we just so thankful tonight, Lord. Lord, I feel such a good spirit tonight, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord, you said we're over two or three and you in the crowd, Lord. In the midst, you know, we got a crowd. We got a crowd here tonight, Lord. If we can preach to you, Lord, we give you honor and glory for it. We pray for all the sick folks that night tonight, brothers and sisters in Christ, our families, Lord. We just pray for one and all. And pray, Lord, that you can touch them all, Lord, through prayer in your precious name. We honor you tonight, Lord. Now, Lord, lead us your way here tonight. Lord, we want everything to be in your will. In your will, Lord, not our will, but your will, and that will be done. In Jesus' name, as we call. It's always a positive answer, Lord, when we call on you. Hallelujah. Lord, we pray for our country. Lord, we just ask you, Lord, to bless it one more time, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord, folks, if they're wondering, Lord, they're wondering from place to place, Lord. Glory to God, Father, tonight, Lord, don't even know which way they're going to go. But, Lord, you know the right way for us, Lord, in the name of Jesus. That is coming to you and lay a burden down to you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. We thank you tonight, Lord. In Jesus' name, the church will say, amen. Have a good day tomorrow. Every single song to you all. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Thank you,
Mom.
I'm good to
see
you.
Glory to God.
I told you she'd be here.
Yeah, I was supposed to have a picnic. I didn't know about.
Oh,
so we're happy.
Long.
Actually,
and God took care of it. And you can say, now God can pay your bills. God took that off my record.
Praise
the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
You know, it's like a big relief when that, when he does
yes,
that.
Indeed.
Praise the Lord. He's a good God. That's what the oral words used to say. Yeah. God is a good God.
He is a good God.
To God be the glory.
Oh, my child, because
Because I know at his time it is going to turn around.
That's right, amen. That's right.
And I'm just being patient. Mm-hmm. And he gave me strength not to cry.
Yeah, praise the Lord.
And he just kept me going. I kept my mind focused on him.
Yes.
Even though that people kept trying to bring up my past, I was like, why are you bringing that up? That's my past. I was like, I rebuke that.
That's
Go
right.
away.
That's right.
And it's like, Lord, I need your strength. Comfort me. Help me.
Yes.
Because you're the only hope I have.
Amen.
He'll never let us down.
And that he protected me from bad drivers on the road.
Praise the Lord.
A lot of vehicles kept coming right at my front end of my vehicle. And I was like, oh, Lord Jesus. But I'm thankful that I made it to church tonight.
Yes, amen.
I've been busy, but I made it here.
Praise the Lord. Sister Wanda, you have a song?
Yeah, but I like to thank the Lord, too. I told my grandchildren, the youngest is three, and said, Mom, Grandma, you come to our picnic? I said, honey, I got to talk to God. Oh, well, when you finish, you come on up. I'm going to cry for him. He's just one of those that, why is that? Uh-huh. He comes up. He stays with me in the morning because he said, couldn't sleep. I don't even know why this is. All kind of questions. And you almost need one of them old time nerve pills. It's just so much to thank him for out of it anyway. When I look around, and see the good things. When I look around and see the good things that he's done for me, and I know I'm not worthy of them all. His blessing is free to give.
To thank him for.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. My spirit. That is. Lord, give it on seven different things here tonight. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Let's go to open up our Bibles up to Matthew tonight. Matthew, let me see which way we're going to go here. You can just read something here the other night. Praise the Lord, I tell you. It's all about Jesus' heart. Hallelujah. Let's start over in the sixth chapter for a little bit. I don't usually use me like this. I usually just go along in there and preach. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Sixth chapter of Matthew. Gospel. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. You see here. Hallelujah. Seventh verse. You know, when we pray, we got to make sure that we're praying in the will of God. And want something hungry, be hungry for what we're praying for. For healing or whatever it may be. Amen?
Yes.
You know, Jesus, he got more mercy and love than you and I can have.
Yep.
He's full of mercy and he's full of love. You know, and he's the only one that can really give us a direct healing, you know, because he made this body.
Yes.
He knows more about this body than any man in the world, because he created us.
Yes.
He made doctors to take care of us, but they can't do what Jesus can do.
That's right, amen.
That's what I'm saying in my message tonight. We got to make sure that we put Jesus first in all things.
Amen.
For the blessings that we need from him. If you need a pure healing, the way you get it is from Jesus. Just like my little daughter there, and she make up her mind to go ahead and call on Jesus from her heart and said, "Look, Lord, I'm going through this. You know what it is, and you know what it's going to take for me to be healed."
That's right.
The Lord's going to speak back to her and say, "Yeah, you come on and you give your soul to me, and I'll give you a guaranteed healing." You know, God works that way. I have seen the Lord work so many different ways. You know, back years ago, I bring this up in my prayers and in my ministry. You know, when they pronounced me dead at the execution, then pronounced me dead in the bad car wreck me and my brother had. You know, glory to God. But the Lord was on the scene in both places.
Yes.
Yes. Amen.
But I called the electrician back in 1977. I called it a wake-up call. The Lord had something, he had to wake me up. The Lord, that was a hard waking. But it was worth it all.
Yes.
You know, sometimes we go through things, don't blame it on God. Mm-hmm. Don't blame it on God.
Yeah.
We got to blame it on ourselves.
That's right.
Yes.
It's something that we did that God didn't approve of, but you know, if we give it to God will approve it. You know what I mean? He'll make something out of it.
Yeah.
Whatever we need. But you know, we got to lift up Jesus. Hallelujah. We got to make sure that we lift up Jesus. Mm-hmm. See, but when you pray, use not vain repetition, as the heathen do, for they think they shall be heard for their much speaking. You know, that's something Jesus don't want. That's other words. You know, a lot of Christians today, glory to God, they would jump up and try and hit somebody else to try to be seen, think they better than you are.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
That's where the church world is today. You know, right now it says that they think they shall be heard for their must be. But he said, "Be not ye therefore like unto them, for your Father knoweth what things you have need before you even ask." And I've been preaching out here at the church for quite a few years now. You know, we don't need to get bad God for anything.
We don't need to tell God that we got to have what we got to have. Just say, look, Lord, you see where I'm hurting at, Lord. You see what kind of little bind I'm in. Can you take care of that for me? And he will.
Yes.
It might not be today. It might not be tomorrow. Mm-hmm. But you're going to get it.
That's right.
You're going to get it. If you just hold on. Mm-hmm. Judith made it quite a few years with that blessing that she had.
Yep.
Yes.
That she got today.
Yep.
She was telling me about it when I first started dating her. You know, about what, you know, some things. And I said, I always told her. I said, Lord, take care of it.
Mm-hmm.
It might take a while, but Lord, take care of it.
Yep.
Make no, hey, there, I don't care if it's $100,000. The Lord, that $100,000 is nothing to him. He owns it anyway.
Yeah.
Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. But the Jesus is speaking here. Hallelujah. He said, but for you need to ask. So after the manner thereof, pray ye, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth. You know, we can get what we need right there in earth before we make it to heaven.
That's right.
You hear me?
Mm-hmm.
Come on now. Y'all help me out here a little bit tonight. People say they got to wait to get to heaven to get all what Jesus has on. No, we can get what we need right here.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. I wasn't figuring on holding on and making to get to heaven and Jesus filled me with the Holy Ghost. I knew he can give it to me right here.
Yep.
Hallelujah. I know he can heal my body right here.
Amen.
You know, people say, well, I know when I get to heaven, I'm going to be healed. I'm going to have a new body. You can have it right here, folks.
Yes.
You can have that new body right here tonight. Glory to God.
Yes.
We don't got to wait on the Lord. Hallelujah. The Lord waits on us. Hallelujah. Because he wants to hear a good word from us. Glory to God. And then, you know, we got to, when we pray to the Lord, glory to God, we got to make sure. You know, like I'm saying, number one is make sure it's in his will. Hallelujah. You go over to God and go to him and say, look, Lord, I'm going to pray, but Lord, I want you to listen close to me, Lord. I want to get this thing right. You know what I need. Hallelujah. Go over to God. I cannot get what I really need unless I pray for it and ask you, Lord, to take it. Amen?
Amen.
You know, this world will be more healthy today if they obey the word of God.
That's right.
We'd be more healthy today, Rhonda, if we obey God more than what we do.
Yes.
You know, God, he's a healthy God. Yes. We don't live for a sick God. We live for a healthy God.
That's right.
We live for a big God.
Yes.
We don't live for
That's
a little
right.
God.
Amen.
We live for a big God.
Yes.
I mean, glory to God. He's big as the world because he made the world.
Amen.
Hallelujah. No, glory to God. He's a big God tonight. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Don't be scared to ask him for anything. Hallelujah, long was of him. Hallelujah,
Amen.
Glory to God. If it's anything of the world, you ain't going to get it. Because,
right.
You know, he's not the world. He's our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Hallelujah, glory to God. I'm just so thankful tonight. I'm so thankful about you all and y'all coming and really get down and listen to the word of God.
Yes.
You know, we got to be good listeners. You know, we're not going to get what the man of God preaching.
Yes.
Hallelujah, glory to God. But you got some that want to just accept what they want to accept. But the Bible said we got to accept of a word
Amen.
From the beginning to the end.
That's
Hallelujah,
right.
Because he is the beginning and he is the end.
Yes.
Hallelujah, come on tonight, folks. Come on, I'm telling you tonight, glory to God, he is. He, Jesus Christ, he raises and puts us asleep and
yes.
gives us the strength to get up and go. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. And forgive our debts as we forgive our debtors.
Amen.
The Lord put me in here tonight. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. I'm telling you tonight, man, we can't lose. You know, we'll never lose by serving Jesus.
Amen.
I'm telling you tonight, folks, out down YouTube land and Facebook land, we'll never lose if you're serving Jesus.
That's right.
Hallelujah, people. It ain't hard to serve Jesus,
no.
But we got a tough road to walk when we serve the Lord. We got a tough road. We got to obey all his commandments,
mm-hmm.
But his statutes to go over to God. And I mean that is something today that he said we must obey all his commandments.
Amen.
Yes, oh, man, that's glory to God. Hallelujah. Y'all have me right now, folks. Hallelujah. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Yes, forever and ever.
Forever. Not just for tonight, or tomorrow, or the next day, or the next day, or the next day, or next week. It's forever.
Yes.
Hallelujah. You know, the Bible says, you know, it's in the Word of God. He said, if I go and prepare a place for you, I come back after you.
Amen.
Amen.
You know, he's coming back.
Yes.
You know, he's preparing for us tonight, folks.
Yeah.
How many believe he's preparing for us tonight?
Yes.
He's preparing for us already for tomorrow.
Yep.
Amen?
That's right.
See, our God, he works 24-7.
Amen.
He's working while you and I are asleep.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Protection.
Yeah.
Protecting us from the evil.
Yeah.
From the old devil trying to pull us up. Hallelujah. But this word, man, this time that we got to eat this word, eat it and digest it.
Amen.
Hallelujah. He said, if you forgive men for their trespass, your Lord and Heavenly Father will also forgive you. This is something I want to preach on. Hallelujah. You know, this is something right here, folks, we might not even feel it in our spirit. You know, forgiving is something that will keep us out of heaven. Forgiving is... For not forgiving your fellow man, or your sister, or your brother,
yeah.
Hallelujah! You know it's hard for people to forgive. You know we might say we forgive, but that unforgiveness is still in that heart.
Yeah.
We got to check our heart other day and see if it's been swept clean.
Yeah.
Hallelujah! Glory to God! And then you know that heart. Jesus Christ looks at the heart.
Yes.
He don't look at the outside of us. You know, only thing he look at is that heart.
Yeah.
He wants that heart to be pure.
Yes.
He said, you know, and want that heart to be pure like mine.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. You know, and he wants us to be just like him. Hallelujah. When we tell somebody something, tell them the truth.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God. Don't beat them in the bush. Hallelujah. Tell them the truth. Hallelujah. Don't tell them you love them and your heart's it's no love there. Hallelujah. You know, people today, you know, you got people out yonder today, might not be here, but in places that you can go and people will love if you walk up and say, how you doing, brother? I love you. How you doing, sister? I love you. You'd be surprised at the people that would come back at you on that. Hallelujah. But I'm telling you tonight, glory to God, I'm going to get on them through here a little bit. Hallelujah. But if ye forgive not men for their trespasses, but your Father forgive us for our to forgive your trespasses. More then, ye fast be not as the hypocrites of a sad temple. For they disfigure their faces, that they may appear to men to fast. Verily I say to you, they have their reward. What is Jesus talking about? We're going to have a
reward.
Yes, sir. We're going to get it's the reward. It's either going to be good or bad. A good report or a bad report. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ tonight, folks, I'm telling you, there's nothing in this world we should let take place before him.
That's right.
Nothing. We should put nothing, something, anything else before God. We got to put him first to get what we really need.
Mm-hmm.
You know, glory to God, I mean, I pray that all the time for him. I said, Lord, you see what's hindering me in my body, Lord. But Lord, you said I will heal.
Yes.
And I leave it at that. I leave it at that.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. The book that you call it. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes, let's get this thing. Let's make the devil mad tonight. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We're going to get on down here a little bit more. 21st verse, Jesus said, well, over your praise is there, then will your heart be also.
Yep.
My. I like being in a big crowd. I want to preach that. I
Hallelujah. I guarantee y'all got some sad faces and about to hit on. Hallelujah. Glory. That's where your treasure is, that's where your heart is also. You know, there are things in that life that Christian folks, I'm talking about us folks, that sometimes we go not thinking about it, and we put love in something else, love all Jesus. We can't do that.
No.
We got to have all that love for Jesus at all times, glory to God, because, man, because we're going to need it.
Yes.
We're going to need it. Hallelujah, but we're going to get on down to the gritty here a little bit to let that people see, really see, glory to God, that we cannot let man step in what Jesus can do for us. We got to make sure that glory to God, hallelujah, just like a man of God up here preaching, we got to make sure that we feel something from him. We got to make sure that he preaching something that we didn't come in here with. That you're going to take back out with you. And then you know you're getting what you really need for your body. You get what you need for your soul. Hallelujah, glory to God. That soul tonight, folks, is very, very important.
Amen.
Hallelujah, glory to God. And we're going to see a little more here for me. But you know, glory to God, that soul tonight, very important. Hallelujah, glory to God. That soul has got to be cleansed and made white. I mean, that soul tonight, glory to God. You got a clean heart, you're going to have a clean soul. Hallelujah, glory to God. I'm telling you tonight, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And the Bible said, if thy eye be evil, thy whole body shall be full of darkness. Hallelujah, glory to God. See, we gotta watch what we look at. We gotta make sure we're looking at the right things. Hallelujah. Glory to God. When we look, we gotta stop wanting. Hallelujah, glory to God. You know, that eye caused a lot of problems. You know, the eye got me into trouble through the years. Hallelujah. I want another automobile. I not put the automobile before I gave Jesus. I could have gave Jesus that money and kept on going. Hallelujah. But you know, we gotta have an automobile. But you know, we need to sit down and talk about that before we grab him and start being an eye surgeon and see all the things that we want, the help done and that we want. No, Jesus, we don't need to do that. Hallelujah. We want what Jesus had for us.
Yes.
That's the eye watching that we need to do. We gotta keep our eye on the Word of God. We gotta keep our eye on Jesus. Hallelujah. Go over to God and see how He's gonna bless. And you know He will bless. We go over to God. You know, praise the Lord. But in darkness, if there be light, that is in thee be darkness. How great is that darkness? Go over to God. Listen to what the Bible, 24th verse, says, no man can serve two masters. Right here is what's going on today. Hallelujah, glory to God. We think it's all right to sit in the pews on Sundays and go out on Monday and be just and live like a bunch of hypocrites all week. Hallelujah, just like Brother Turner said. You know, when you get preaching this word right here, hallelujah, they'll some of them will get up and walk out on you. Hallelujah, glory to God. And I heard Brother Turner many times when preaching what I'm preaching here tonight. Hallelujah, but a different way. I heard him, he said, you can get up and leave if you want to. It don't make no difference to me. But he said, you're walking down on the main one. And he said, I advise you not to do that.
Yeah.
But he said, Jesus can see whether you love him or not.
Yeah.
If you love him, you will sit under this ministry. Hallelujah. But if you don't love him, you ain't going to sit under him. You got to love God to sit under my gospel.
Yeah.
You gotta, I mean, I'm serious. I'm the same way. You got to love my Lord and Savior to sit under the gospel that we preach.
Yeah.
We preach the old apostolic way, and you ain't going to change it for nothing in the world. Hallelujah. It's up with you. Jesus don't change. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Man might change it, but God won't change. Hallelujah. That's why we shouldn't be changing anything. Glory to God. The Bible said don't add one, don't add two, and don't take from.
That's right.
Hallelujah. That's what they're doing today. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I'm telling you, when the scripture right here says no man can serve two masters, they're doing it. Hallelujah. For either he will hate the one, or love the other. That man, this is right here. But Jesus is talking this. Hallelujah. He said, you know, tonight, glory to God. Jesus said, we're either loving him or loving the devil. Hallelujah. Glory to God. But when you get Jesus Christ in your life,
you let him come. Oh, glory to God. You let him get come complete into your life. Hallelujah. And you keep him on the inside. Hallelujah. That way he can live inside. Glory to God. And you inside. Boy, I mean, I'm telling you one thing tonight. Glory to God. I mean, it's a tough life. It'll keep you straight with the Lord. Yes. Hallelujah. You know, I want to. If I gotta go through something hard to make sure I'm still in the line with Jesus Christ, I don't care. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I want to be just like him. He said we are. He said, I've got the power I got, you have also. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You know, Jesus said, look, glory to God. He said, you know, just like the talking about the mustard seed, the size of a mustard seed, you can move that mountain. Hallelujah. Glory to God. If Jesus moved it, we can move it. Hallelujah. Amen. But it takes praying and fasting to do it. We just can't agree up and do what we think. That, you know, praying and fasting is what we all need. Hallelujah, glory to God. Hallelujah. Hold on to one. Despise the other. You cannot serve God and man. Man. Mm-hmm. You know, that's something today, though. It's sad. It's a sad situation. You got folks today in these churches that love the preacher more than they do God. I've seen that happen to Sister Mama so many times. They think more of the preacher man than they do God. It's a shame.
Yeah.
You know, I told y'all, I tell y'all years ago, don't come in praise me, give all praise to Jesus.
Amen.
Yeah. I'm just like you all. I'm struggling to, you know, I'm just struggling along to make heaven my home. Hallelujah. That's what, you know, I'm not struggling, but I'm just following along. Just glory to God, make sure that I can get work with Jesus where I need to be. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Praise the Lord. Praise God. Hallelujah. And I know. Oh, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Glory. Therefore, the 34th verse, the devil, take no thought, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or what we shall be clothed? For after all these things do the Gentiles seek. For your heavenly Father knoweth that you have need of all these things. See what I'm saying? You know, glory to God. The Lord know what we need. Tomorrow ain't even come yet.
Yep.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. And you know that Melissa's daughter, right here tonight, glory to God, that scripture, the Lord knows tonight that Amy needs a healing. Glory to God, but the Lord, I have a deal for her. I feel good about the thing. She gonna have to soon give in. Hallelujah. She gonna soon give in. I mean, if she's not listening to that promises of her, and let him keep holding her back, she'll get rid of what she got and be healed. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We want to keep Jason. Charlie called me last night. Said that his nephew found him. Had a liver that put him in the hospital last night. He's good today. So maybe that's good today tonight. Anyway, I don't want to be in my message on that. But that's what God did.
Mm-hmm.
He waited before he got rid of that COVID and then put him on there now. Put him second place and put him in there tonight. And I pray the Lord to do all the work for him. Hallelujah. So, therefore, take no thought for tomorrow. For tomorrow shall take care, though, for the things of itself, sufficient and through the day is the evil thereof. Trouble. We all know it's trouble, John.
Yes.
But we all got strength to stay away from that trouble.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. We all got power to stay away from it. But you know, I'm telling you tonight, I might not be like everybody, but I'm a firm believer. Glory to God. When you're living for Jesus and you're living your best, if Satan ain't coming at you, something's wrong. Satan won't come at you if he's already got you. People say, what do you mean, Virgin? I said, that's his job. I said, whether you're a child of God or who you are, that devil's going to still come at you regardless. You know, especially, and I'm telling you that I know this evening. Hallelujah. And she knows the truth. You know, when we set me on island, that's when the devil can tear us apart.
Yeah.
That's why we got to stay busy. And you know, staying busy right here in the Word of God.
Amen.
I keep that Bible laying yonder when you sit down on the couch or you in the kitchen brushing your dishes and you begin to feel something come on. Stop that right then and go tonight and grab the Word of God and begin to read.
Amen.
And you watch what will happen in your life. Hallelujah. There's a lot of times I used to carry a little small Bible with me, kept it in my front pocket, my t-shirt, uptime I've been to work. Hallelujah. I ain't done that for the last couple years. Hallelujah. But man, I'm telling you, when I got feeling something, glory to God. See, I'm one of them. I need to get back doing what I always did for the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm not ashamed to admit it. But you know, I feel something coming on. I would put my brush down in the paint and I begin to read. I begin to read. My spirit begin to flow. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And I could get back what I was really thinking about. You know, glory to God. And the Lord put me right back in the spirit. And glory to God. And man, I put that Bible back up. I took it and thanked the Lord. And put it back in my pocket. I began to paint and never had a problem the whole that day. I'm telling you, this word is what it's going to take.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. I'm going to read here a little bit tonight. If America, if the country, our country that we live in, if they will make up their mind and come back and start seeking God. Seventh verse is seven. He said, ask and it shall be given you. Seek and you shall find. Knock and it shall be opened to you.
Yes.
Well, all it is tonight, folks. Read that one to Emily but listen when you go back there down. That scripture right there. Read that to her. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. It's the eggs. Hallelujah. For of the one that eggs it receive, and he that seeketh find, and to him that knocketh, it shall be opened.
Uh-huh.
Jesus is here tonight saying, if any of us need whatever we need, just knock on the door. Knock on the door. Jesus! I'm here. I need you, Lord. And he'll open the door.
Yeah.
And then tell me my fault.
Yep.
Give it to him. Don't take it to your neighbor. Don't take it over the next door. Take it to Jesus.
Yes.
You know, people got a bad habit sometimes that take the problem to the next one. And their problems will be worse than what you got. I'm serious. That's the truth of us spoken. Mm-hmm. But I've heard Brother Turtle preach that a lot of times down in the tent meetings. Hallelujah. He said, no, we take a problem to the wrong people. He said, you go next door to your neighbor, but Lord mercy, he got more problems you got. Say, take it to Jesus. That's what we got to start doing. We got to talk, give other things to the Lord. That's good scripture there. He said, just ask, it shall be given. Seek. We got to seek the Lord.
Yes.
We got to seek the good Lord. My goodness, we got spare time. We need to get down on our knees and seek the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. He said, if being, no, he said, you ask for a fish, will he give you a servant? Then he said, in the next verse, he said, if then being evil know how to give good gifts unto your children, how much more shall your Father, which is in heaven, give good tidings to them to ask him.
Yeah.
Good. Won't be nothing bad. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. That's just like one time, is it? That was just one scripture. I was speaking about the dog before I didn't get in. But I say, I don't know what I was eating one time. I didn't like it. And this is true. I didn't like it. I threw that to the back door. Throw that to the dog.
my wife in the house, and I heard the dog barking. So I wasn't where the dog barking at. Barking at that food that I thrown at the door. Let me know that you didn't eat it, and I'm not going to eat it. As you like, what's it, what we got, you see where I'm coming from here tonight?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I don't want something that somebody else throw away. I want what Jesus got for me.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I know it's good and clean.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I remember buying a good meal, buying some new clothes. I believe in that. I wear clothes. Sometimes good clothes. I bring them home. First thing I do, I throw them in the word machine and curse the devil. And the Lord makes them bubble clean.
Yep.
Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. But that dog kept barking, barking. I put the word of that thing barking at. And I couldn't eat it. I think it was a steak or something. And Barry, the dog was my coon dog. That's all it was. And Vonda, I kept looking at him. Went back up. It was tough. I couldn't even chew on one bit and try to get it to work. Yeah. This part of the Bible here now. See, Jesus now, if Jesus would have back in the hand, that would have been all nice and tender. Just like that good sweet word that he gives me, you know, God's love in it and all that, you know. But my goodness, I went back at the door, and Lord, you know something, you know, the dog, but he said, you know, if the dog ain't eating, why the Lord we're going to eat? Hallelujah, glory to God. Jesus, you know, Jesus, he wants us to eat clean things, amen?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. So I went back at the door, and listen, and that clean dog was taking that big old tent steak that was big for me to eat, and throwing them in the iron. And bark at it. That's what people do when they bargain. They bargain, but they bargain at the wrong thing.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Go over to God. Look like that dog went over. Bark up for good, ain't it?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I'm serious. We got to be careful what we bark at. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I can't help that enough. Oh, go over to God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. He said, therefore, all things whatsoever ye would that men shall do to you, do even so to them, for this is the law and the prophets.
Mm-hmm.
He said, enter ye in the straight gate, for wide is the gate, and broad is the way, so that leadeth to destruction, and many there which would go in therein. Because straight is the gate, and narrow is the way which leadeth into life, and few there be that could find it.
Mm-hmm.
A few, he said. Beware of false prophets which come to you in sheep's clothing and immorally that are raven wool. Right there. Some of this preaching that you hear. I know I'm not preaching. I don't not know, man. You know, I'm just saying if it's the truth, it's the truth. We got to stay in the truth.
Yeah.
Some of the things I hear preachers preach today, some of the people are not saved. No one is not saved. They're not giving no word to even that will stir up the heart. You know, when we preach the word, there shall be a stirring going on in the house of God. It should be a stern. I'm serious. That word should be stern. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And you know, the more we stir, glory to God, the thicker it's going to get for us. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You know, and the thicker it's getting, the devil can't take it. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And I'm telling you, glory. And you know, this word that Jesus said, you know, he means a word of it. Glory to God. Let me keep on reading here. I feel the Holy Ghost now. Hallelujah. He said, a good tree cannot bring forth evil fruit, neither can a corrupted tree bring forth good fruit.
Yeah.
Other tree that bringeth not forth good fruit is hewn down and cast into the fire.
Yeah.
You know, just like a tree. You got dead limbs on, take them off.
Yeah.
You take the dead limbs off, that tree get more prettier.
Mm-hmm.
That's what we got to do. We got to get the deadness out of us.
Yes.
We got to come alive in Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Listen to me, folks. We got to make sure that we're alive in the Lord. Hallelujah, glory to God. The Bible said right here, he said, another one that saith me, Lord, Lord, the other one that saith to me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven.
But he that doeth the will of my Father, which is in heaven. We got to do the will of God, you know, of all things.
Yep.
You know, the Bible also said, right now, if you look at that verse, you know, Jesus said, everybody said, Lord, Lord, it's not going to make it. Shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth evil of my Father, which is in heaven. And say to me, Lord, Lord, we have not prophesied thy name, and in thy name we have cast out devils. In thy name done many wonders. You ain't going to do it no other way but in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
You may look like you try to pray over something, and you don't mention Jesus. It ain't going to work. You put that in Jesus' name, it will work.
Amen.
That's why we're not getting ahead as far as I used to fall. We're not taking it to the Lord when we pray. We get down, we pray. Say, Lord, I need you. Oh, Lord, I need your touch. We need to get down on my knees. Say, Lord, if it's your will, Lord, can you heal my body? Can you touch my body tonight and set me free of this pain that I have, Lord? Lord, I know you can do it, Lord. I'm asking, Lord, nobody else can do it. But Lord, I know in your will, you can do it. If it's your will. Hallelujah. He's doing it. That's not a time I can say. When I really got serious with the Lord, my prayers have been answered. If it didn't, I would stay back with him until I did get an answer. Hallelujah. But tonight, I'm going to close here in a little while. There's something tonight here that I'm going to say. We all do need a closer walk with the Lord.
Yes.
We all do.
Yes.
We need to get more in our hearts how to pray. Get the blessings that the Lord is going to have for us. We got to get down. We got to plead with the Lord. I can ride down the road. Down 66, I was praying off and on all the way down out of day to Manassas. Then I get back in that vehicle, I'll pray back. But this morning, the enemy must have been like, because I was praying with Jacob, and I come off 2:30, off 66, the Lord was with me, that I will bring the Lord in on another thing. But Sister Ronan, I come off the ramp, I look right there, was a white work band, I don't mind, right at my beard, coming right on to my side. And man, I took that stern wheel, hit the gas, got over in front of him, he stopped on the other side. But I said, Lord, thank you for having your hand on this bill.
Yes.
Amen.
I mean, I was coming in, Lord, that's a dangerous spot coming on 234 anyway. With all them cars coming up to 234 or more off the bypass, off 29. But anyway, let me see here. Thank the Lord right down to me here tonight. Hallelujah. Make sure that we stay rock solid with the Lord. Because he is the Lord.
Amen.
24, 25 there. Hallelujah. You can see. When we don't, when we rip away from Jesus, it can happen real fast. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. But that's I'm going to close. That's what the Holy Ghost stopped me at. That's why I'm going to obey the Lord. Hallelujah. When you obey the Lord, you can get more from the Lord.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
That's a big amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Leave that right there. Come on back up. We're going to sing a closing song. You got any more of them? Walk up and go for pain. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I hope some people will be here tonight. I got to call them up, right? Like I do Jesus. I called Brother James, a couple of nubs, and ate some other mad apples. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Y'all saw the light.
Yeah.
hope I know this and sing what.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the
Lord.
Hallelujah.
Anybody else need prayer?
On 10:30, let's really come in. Let's really get into it, dear Lord.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you, Lord Jesus, for the privilege to be able to come into your house and to hear your word and for you to feed our souls and to keep us strong and to keep us going. We thank you and we praise you that you keep us safe, you watch over us and you help us with everything, that there's nothing that you can't do because all things are possible with you because the word says, all things are possible with you.
Yes.
And I stand on the word of God, and I believe in the word of God, and I know the word of God is from you.
Thank you, Jesus.
And I ask, Lord Jesus, to watch over all of us and take us back to our home safely.
Thank you, Lord.
And to bless this offering,
yes,
and to bless it a thousandfold. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hallelujah.